the farm, where the crop was grown, where they broke, the specific area, what was supplied in terms of water, if fertilizer was used, how much fertilizer was used, what chemical was used. You should be able to have all that, because it's a requirement for herbs and spices for export. We'll be discussing that later. Then, the post-handling techniques for herbs is important for you to understand. It varies from herb to herb. Some of them are very delicate. Some of them, the market requirement is enough to keep you going. Because you harvest, you generate, you keep harvesting. Some of them are perennial. You have to keep harvesting throughout. Yeah, it's not just once, one-off harvesting, but you keep harvesting and keeps reestablishing itself. So it's like somebody who is growing maize. Maize that you wait for, how many months?
Six, seven
months. Then, as the crop is growing, you find that it's attacked by maize lethal necrotic disease. You have to keep spraying, you have to weed. Yeah? At the end of it all, you don't have a market. For stevia is becoming popular in Kenya. Yeah? People are growing stevia as a substitute of the normal sugar. Because it's low energy sugar. So it's becoming very popular. Moringa. You know about moringa. Moringa, you can use the leaves, you can use the bark, you can use the roots. It has its own medicinal values. Chia seeds. Chia seeds are very expensive. You add value. How do you add value to herbs and spices? You can crush them. Grind. You've seen cinnamon. Cinnamon, how is it in form of what? You bought cinnamon from a supermarket.
Powder.
Yeah?
It's powder.
Yes. Yes, it's grounded and packed and labeled. Yeah? That's value addition. Because they mainly focus on the export market, there are stringent regulations that we need to adhere to. One, you need to adhere to the local requirements for exporting horticultural produce. Do we know that? What are the requirements for exporting horticultural produce from Kenya? What do you need? Do you know? You have an idea? I don't know.